As developers, it's very important for us to automate and delegate some of the tasks that we do. If you notice that you're doing a specific thing over and over again, then it's time to automate that thing. This helps you work smarter and work faster because you have already automated the process and then you don't have to do them yourself. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, my name is Gift Egwenu. In this channel, I talk about tech, career, and my life as a developer. In today's video, I am going to be sharing 5 developer tools that you can start using to help you be more productive or to help speed up your workflow. If by the end of watching this video you are already familiar with all the tools that I shared, then I'll be very impressed. But if not, I would like for you to check them out. Today's video is sponsored by Pluralsight. Pluralsight is a platform for developers or IT professionals to level up or learn new skills. Pluralsight is offering its entire platform for free for this month, April. Over 7,000 expert-led courses are available to you to help you learn or upskill on relevant technologies in tech. For you to get access to this, you have to sign up. So I'll be leaving a link in the description box below for you to sign up and get access to this amazing offer. Thank you so much for sponsoring this video. Let's start by sharing the first tool I have on my list. This tool is called Quokka. It's a tool that allows you rapidly prototype JavaScript or TypeScript in your editor. The good thing about this is that when you're using it, you get to see the runtime values update immediately and they're literally displayed in the code. Now, Quokka makes prototyping, learning and testing JavaScript or TypeScript code very fast because by default you don't need to set up any configuration for it. No configuration is required. All you need to do is just start up a JavaScript file and you already have it working. But first you need to install an extension. So you need to install the Quokka.js extension. You can use it in VS Code, WebStorm, Sublime or Atom, but I use VS Code, so I'm going to be using it in VS Code. Quokka has 2 different editions. It has the community edition, which is free for everybody, but there are some limitations to it. Have that in mind. They also have their pro edition, which you have to pay for, but it has advanced feature. Right now I use the community edition and I will just show you like quickly how to use it. So this is my VS Code, right? I'll just delete this and recreate the file that I created. So once you have that extension installed, which I can show you here, once you have it installed, now all you need to do is use Command Shift P to start up a new JavaScript file so you can see it, because I already used it recently. So once you create a new JavaScript file, then we can prototype whatever we want to do. Now, let me show you the thing that keeps blowing my mind. So if I do something like countries, you can see you get runtime values immediately as you type. If I save countries equals, name is not defined because I haven't defined that yet. Name equals Nigeria. And we do capital. Now, I'm already seeing the next tool that I'm going to show you, but I won't spoil it yet. I already see it in action because I already use it here. And lastly, population. Let's say 50k. Now, if I am to console this countries object that I created, so console.log countries, I get to see the values immediately. Do you see this? And it's also logged in the output as well. This is just one part of how you can use, like, for quickly testing that your JavaScript code works. I can already see this useful if you're like explaining JavaScript code to somebody. And a lot of us as developers, we do this in the browser console, right? So instead of doing that in the browser console, just test out if something is working. This is something you can use because you don't have to configure anything. It just works out of the box. I really like it. The next tool on our list is called Tap9. I already gave you a spoiler. If you caught that spoiler, then that's very nice of you. But anyway, Tap9 is the number one leading AI completion tool out there with over 1 million developers using it in different programming languages. I already use Tap9 and I've been using it for a couple of months now. It has been a game changer. It just works like magic. Like everybody that I've used this would know what I'm talking about. So Tap9 was created to help developers code faster, which is the reason why I'm making this video in the first place. Reduce mistakes and discover best coding practices using machine learning.
So it works with different programming languages like JavaScript, C++, Java, and it automatically knows. Like, sometimes I feel like it has sixth sense. It knows the next thing you're going to write. And this is because it's behind the scenes, it has AI-powered technology. So it currently has support for VS Code and some other code editors as well, and some other programming languages. Now, the same thing applies here. Tab 9 is completely free for you to use, but if you would like to extend the features that you have, right now I'm on the free plan and it works good for me. But if you like to like have your team use it or just have advanced completion, you know, then you can consider using the pro or the team version. But yeah, the free version works for me and I definitely would love that you start using it. And maybe I should mention this, go into the technical bits. It uses GPT-2 and this was quite popular, I think, a year ago when everybody was like scared that machine learning is going to take over everybody's job as developers. Anyway, Tab9 is trained using GPT-2 models. Anyway, let's see how it works. For me to be able to use it in VS Code, again, I have to install the Tab9 extension. Don't worry, I'll leave the links to all of this in the description box, but I'm using this extension called Tab9 Auto Completion and I'll just show you the magic it does. Now, in order for me to show you the magic that this does, I am going to be trying it out in my code. This is my code for one of my websites. Now, it's an auto completion tool, meaning that it can automatically, it can automatically suggest potential things that you want to write. This is just, for instance, I say I'm giving it a class of, how does it know I want to give it a grid class? It helps you autocomplete a lot of things and say we want to do, these are all Tab9 suggestions that you see. If it doesn't matter what code you're writing, as long as you've been using it for a while. So I feel like on underground, it trains like a model to know like the kind of code. So if you're writing with, for instance, Tailwind CSS, he already knows all the Tailwind classes, I think. I don't know the underworkings of this tool, but I know that it works quite well. If you're thinking of using it, then please check it out. The third tool I would like to share with you is very vital, because as front-end developers, we always have to use like colors, right? So this tool is called Coolors, like cool colors. I don't know if that's the idea they had with the name, but Coolors is a color scheme generator that helps you generate different palettes. Apart from using this for code, I also use it for design. So I can see how this tool would be also beneficial for designers. It helps you auto-generate different color schemes that you can use. I mean, it's quite better than having, can you see this? It's very much better and intuitive to use as well than having to figure out, oh, okay, I should use AAA or I should use DDD. You just come here, pick a color that works, and it does not just give you one color, it gives you a color scheme, like a color palette to use. I really like it, and you can change the different palettes using the space key. So I use this a lot. Oh, this is so nice. I can keep doing this and not stop. Anyway, let's move on to the other two. This one is called OhMyZish. OhMyZish, I think that's how it's pronounced, but I've been using this for a long time, for a very long period, and it's auto-powers your terminal process. Like, if you're using this and you're working in the terminal, you would know what I mean. From helping it, your terminal, like changing the look of your terminal to look even more pretty, to like helping you automate stuff as well. So OhMyZish is an open source driven framework for managing your Zish configuration. I don't know if it's called Zish or Zish, but it comes bundled with thousands of helper functions, themes, plugins that you can use. I currently use it in my terminal. If I go back to VS Code and I go to my terminal, this is what I'm currently using. And I have access to do something like GST. This is my Git status, or I can do GB. This is Git branch, like, because I'm using the Git plugin. There are a lot of things you can also do. And I feel like I'm not even utilizing OhMyZish enough, right? Apart from having a lot of themes that you can pick, like, these are the different themes that you can use for your terminals. It also has a lot of plugins, over 275 plus plugins that I think I'm only using, I'm not even using enough of it, right? It has a lot of plugins. I use the Git one. I think I use the Bundler one as well. Yeah, I don't think I use a lot of them anyways, but this is something I'm going to come back to and look for the ones that I should be using that I'm not already using. But yeah, check it out. Oh My Zish, very wonderful. Oh My Zish is simply amazing. I wish I could have installed it earlier. I think this is everybody when they found out about this tool. Finally, the last tool that I'll be sharing with you, this one I recently found out literally a week ago, and it has been amazing. Like, checking it out, you would wonder, oh my god, I literally have to do this every single time. But anyway, devutils.app is a app or a toolbox for developer, and it works offline as well. That's just the icing on the cake. It works also offline. It has several different tools that you can use. Like, you know how you always have to go to Google to look for a base64 encoder decode that you can then go there and, you know, decode a base64. You get what I mean? You don't have to do that anymore. Or you want to, I've done this one a lot, I want to convert YAML to JSON, or JSON to YAML, then I have to go on Google and search for a tool that helps me do that. But you see, I don't have to do that anymore, because with this tool, devutils.app, I have all of that, and they are all available offline, so I don't actually need internet to be able to do that. Now, how do I use it? I'm going to show it to you here. Now, this is it right here. Just need to make it bigger, I think. These are all the tools you have. So you can do Unix time converter, JSON formats. You can validate your JSON here. You can do a lot of things, JSON to YAML. You know, we can beautify your JavaScript. Lorem Ipsum. Who doesn't want Lorem Ipsum generator? You know, QR reader generator and string inspector. A lot of these tools are useful tools for us as developers that we use on a daily basis, or we have to look up on a daily basis. So it's very nice to have this tool. I'm going to be sharing a link to this tool. It is actually not free, so you have to buy it, but it's just a one-time purchase. Once you have it once, then you don't have to buy it again. I'm going to be leaving a link to that in the description box below. So that brings me to the end of this part of the video. Don't forget that Pluralsight is offering its entire platform for free for this month of April. And to further help you learn more about how to boost your productivity as a developer, Pluralsight has several courses on developer productivity, and I would like to share some of them. This first one is actually a skill part on using Bash and Z Shell. So I already mentioned Oh My Zish, and there are other videos that you can watch in your spare time to learn about how to automate your process. The next one I'd like to share is for JavaScript developers, how to build a JavaScript developer environment. And this course is created by Corey House. So he's sharing like some of the things you need to know to set up a JavaScript environment, things like linters, code editors, transpilers, bundlers, a lot of all those things, how to, you know, structure your code base and how to build, how to deploy. So this is also something, a course that you can actually check out. And finally, this one is more of a soft skill kind of course. I think it's Productivity Tips for Busy Tech Professionals. So Richard, who is the creator of the course, is going to share some productivity tips for you as a tech professional. And it's only 59 minutes, so you should definitely check it out.
If you have any tools that you use that I did not mention that has really helped you, please leave the names and the links to them in the comment section. I would definitely love to check out what you all are using.